church. Want to hear a joke? Okay, knock, knock. Gladys. Aren't you glad it's time for junior church? Whew, I cracked myself up. Hey, well, it's time for junior church. This is a place where you can sing, dance, and have fun, all while learning about the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Well, let's not waste any time. Let's get right to it. Can I get one of the McPhersons to give us a scripture and a welcome today?
Good morning, Bexton.
I'm Anaya.
And I'm Peyton.
And welcome to Junior Church.
Good morning. Today I will be reading to you Matthew, the 5th chapter, verse 44 to 45. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he makes his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and the unjust. I just read to you Matthew, the 5th chapter, 44th verse, and the 45th verse. Now, can we bow our heads in a word of prayer? Lord God, please forgive us for our sins that we've done knowingly and unknowingly. Lord, thank you for watching over us as we go through this pandemic. Lord, I pray for people who don't have the stuff that they need to while we go through this pandemic. Lord, I just pray that you can keep people healthy. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Hey everybody, this is Sister Natalie with today's song of praise. I'm in the Lord's army. You ready? Let's sing.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom over enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom over enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom over enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Hey everybody, are you ready for a great study with lots of fun? Then let's get started. Do you remember the Books of the Bible song? That song includes the books of the prophets. There are 17 books of the prophets. Do you think you can remember them? Can we sing them together? Here we go. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. Oh, I really like that part. Those are the 17 prophets in the Old Testament. Now, how many of you remember how many are called major prophets? That's right. 5 major prophets. 5 major prophets, 12 minor prophets. And no, the major prophets aren't called major because they're more important. They're called major because their writings were longer than the minor prophets. And as we said last week, they just had more to say. The major prophets are Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, and Daniel. Can you say those with me? Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, and Daniel. Now this time, you say them and I'll listen. Are you ready? Great job! You did it! Last week we learned about the major prophet Isaiah. This week we learned about the major prophet Jeremiah. The prophets wrote the books that are called by their name. Jeremiah is believed to have written both the book of Jeremiah and the book of Lamentations. The word lamentation means crying and mourning. Jeremiah is called the crying or weeping prophet because he was sad that the people wouldn't stop doing bad things. What's the word we use for bad things again? That's right, sin. Like Jeremiah, we should all be sad about sin. Look at these pictures. If you see someone doing good, give them a great big smile because good things make God smile. But if you see somebody doing something bad, that's sinning, give me a sad face and do like Jeremiah and cry out, "That's sin." Let's look at this first diagram. Lying, that's sin. What about sharing? What about stealing? That's sin. What about saying bad words? That's sin. What about talking back to your parents? That's sin. What about obeying your parents? Good things make God smile. So the next time you're tempted to sin, remember that bad things, sin, makes God sad. I want to see God smile. Don't you? Jeremiah means God appoints. And the word appoint means to be chosen or picked out for a special job. You know, like being picked out to be on a team. That was a great name for Jeremiah because God appointed or picked him out to be his prophet even before he was born. That means that while he was still small in his mommy's tummy, he was already important to God, and so are you. Before you were even born, God knew you, he loved you, and he has a special job for you to do one day too. God appeared to Jeremiah when he was young and told him what he wanted him to do. Jeremiah thought he was too young to speak for God, but God promised to be with him and to put his words in his mouth. It doesn't matter how young or old you are, God can still use you to do good things. Jeremiah thought he was too young to speak for God, but God promised to be with him and to put his words in his mouth. It doesn't matter how young or old you are, God can still use you to do good things. God called Jeremiah to be his prophet when he was young. Do you remember what we said a prophet was? You said God's messenger? Or someone whom God chose to speak to the people for him? That's right. God spoke directly to the prophet, and the prophet told the people what God wanted them to know. He told them what they should do, what they should not do, and even warned them of what would happen if they failed to obey. If they failed to obey God, boy, would there be consequences. Consequences. Now that's a big word. Consequences mean something that happens because of what you did or because of what you didn't do. Consequences could be something good or something bad. For example, if you eat all your vegetables like your mother says, you'll grow strong muscles. Consequences of obeying your mom or your dad and eating your vegetables. But if you eat too much candy, even though your daddy said not to, you might get a tummy ache. Consequences. Consequences are what happens because of something you did or something you didn't do. When you disobey your mom or dad, you should expect consequences. Well, God is our Heavenly Father, and in His Word, the Bible, He teaches us the things that we should do and we shouldn't do so that we won't have to get bad consequences. Jeremiah tried to warn the people of Israel about the bad consequences of disobeying God. They were stealing, killing, lying, treating each other unfairly. God had loved them and blessed them, but instead of worshiping Him, they insisted on worshiping fake gods. What do we call fake gods again? Idols. Yeah, that's right, idols. Not only did they worship idols, but they thought that it was all right to worship the true God of Israel and to worship the idols too. This made God really angry. He sent Jeremiah to warn them that if they didn't stop it, there would be consequences.
Your ancestors to keep forever. Don't be fooled into thinking that you will never suffer because the temple is here. It is a lie.
Asher, you are head priest of the temple. You must stop Jeremiah from preaching this gloom and doom.
Do you really think you can steal, murder, commit adultery, lie, and burn incense to Baal and all those other new gods of yours, and then come here and stand before God in his temple and chant, "We are safe"? Only to go right back to all those evils again?
Did you know Jeremiah recently went to every entrance of the temple, berating anyone bringing goods into the city to sell on the Sabbath?
Use your authority to stop him, Pasher, or look like a fool for allowing this to continue.
Don't you yourselves admit that this temple, which bears his name, has become a den of thieves? Surely God sees all the evil going on here!
Let us destroy this man and all his words.
Let us cut him down so his name will be forgotten forever.
I will make arrangements.
The people were angry with Jeremiah for telling them the truth. He told them about their sins and wasn't even afraid to tell the bad priest, those who were supposed to be preaching the truth of God's word, that they were sinning too. What made things really bad is there were other men, false prophets that God didn't choose, who were telling the people not to believe what Jeremiah told them. Jeremiah said if they didn't stop sinning, God would send Nebuchadnezzar, the wicked king of Babylon, and his armies from the north. They would burn down the city of Jerusalem, including the temple, and put the people in chains and take them away to work for them in their own land as slaves. But the false prophets made fun of Jeremiah. They told the people, don't believe what Jeremiah said. They said everything will be all right. God would never destroy his own temple. But God would destroy it because the people were even sinning in the temple. Jeremiah wasn't afraid to speak out. He preached to the people. He preached to the bad preachers and the false prophets. And he told them that God would punish them all. That was pretty brave. You know what? I think that we need to use our imaginations to go back to the city of Jerusalem to hear Jeremiah for ourselves. Would you like to do that? Remember how we do it. Use our imaginations. We turn around, touch the ground, and there we go. Are you ready? Here we go. Use our imaginations. Turn around, touch the ground, and off we go.
Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations.
Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a youth.
Do not say, "I am a youth," for you shall go to all to whom I send you, and whatever I command you, you shall speak. Do not be afraid of their faces. For I am with you to deliver you. Behold, I have put my words in your mouth. See, I have this day set you over the nations and over the kingdoms, to root out and to pull down, to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant. You will stand against the whole land, the kings, officials, priests, and people of Judah. They will fight against you, but they shall not prevail against you, for I am with you to deliver you.
Instead of admitting that they had done wrong and telling God that they were sorry, the people got angry with Jeremiah. They beat him up and threw him into prison. Poor Jeremiah. But Jeremiah didn't stop preaching. He kept right on telling them what God said. He kept telling them the truth. All God ever wanted was their obedience, but they said no. All God wants is our obedience too. He wants us to obey him by doing good, obeying our parents, and treating others fairly. When we do that, the consequences will be God's blessings. In Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 through 23, Jeremiah wrote, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not completely beaten, for his love never fails. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness." Hey, come a little closer to the screen so I can see you. Well, I can't see you all. But hey, I see Arde, Janiyah, Kayla, Angie, Amber, Hey Hope, Isis, Parker, Deshaun, Grayson, Jade, Evan, Joshua, Janiyah, Brandon, Arde, Andre, Layla, Nevaeh, Trinity, Hey Mason, Lacey, Lance, Parker, Izzy, Jonah, Carson, Kenny, Joel, is that you, John? Xavier, Peyton, Avery, TJ, Trent. Oh, so glad to have all of you with us. Be sure to come back next week because I'm going to be looking for you. Join us next week when Sister Andrea will tell us all about the prophet Ezekiel. Bye now. Have a great week.
Good morning. Today we learned about the minor prophets. Let's get started with our activity to see what you remember. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you, and before you were born, I consecrated you. I appointed you a prophet to the nation. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 4 and 5. God knows us and he chooses us. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 4 through 10. Stay focused. God has a plan and a purpose for each life he created. Even though we have doubts and fears, God will help us complete his work. Name the 12 minor prophets: Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. You got it. So let's play tic-tac-toe. God wants to use us at any age. In this game of tic-tac-toe, we will decide what is right and what is wrong. Will you listen to God and obey? That's right. Will you do whatever you want to do and disobey God? That's wrong. God gives us strength to work for him. Right. God doesn't use kids. God will use me when I'm older. Wrong. God has given us love and grace and promises to be with us to do his work, whatever that might be. Right. God has a plan for me. Right. God did not give Jeremiah a special job to tell his messages to the people. Wrong. I will do it my way. I know what I'm doing. Wrong. Three in a row, tic-tac-toe. You win! Behold, I have put my words in your mouth. See, I have set you this day over nations and over kingdoms, to pluck up and to break down, to destroy and to overthrow, to build and to plant. Jeremiah chapter 1, verses 9 and 10. God made you a winner. And as always, thank you for learning with us today. You can contact us at hopenation8804@gmail.com. See you next week.
Hi, my name is Chloe. I'm happy to go over the plan of salvation with you. If you're wondering how to get into God's family, I hope this helps. First is the Black Cross. The Black Cross represents sin, which is anything you do, say, or think that disobeys God. The Bible says in Romans 3:23, "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." This verse shows that no one is perfect and that everyone has disobeyed God. Next is the Red Cross. The Red Cross represents Jesus' blood. In Romans 6:23, the first part says, "For the wages of sin is death." This means that our choice to sin has a punishment of death. But there's good news. The rest of the verse says, "But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." Because we sin, we deserve that punishment of death. But God loves us so much that he is willing to give us something that we don't deserve, a free gift of eternal life through his Son. Jesus took our punishment by shedding his blood and dying in our place. Next is the White Cross. The White Cross represents clean. Jesus makes us clean by covering our sins with his blood. Psalm 51:7 says, "Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow." The sacrifice that Jesus made erased all of the bad things we do. For every time we've lied or disobeyed our parents or talked about someone else, Jesus' death washes all of that away. Next is the Green Cross. The Green Cross represents everlasting life. If you would like your sins forgiven and to be washed whiter than snow, God wants that too. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." God did all the work, and all you have to do is accept what he did. Jesus died for you and rose for you so that you could live, and he didn't have to. Last is the Gold Cross. The Gold Cross represents the crown of glory. God promises to reward those who have faith and trust in Jesus. In Revelation 2:10b, it says, "Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give you a crown of life." No matter what happens in life, you can keep your trust in God. There will still be problems in this world, but Jesus has overcome the world and made you a child of God. And God doesn't let anyone mess with his children. Choose God today.
Hey everybody, we're back with today's song of praise. I'm in the Lord's army. If you're ready, let's sing it together.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I'm in the Lord's army. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. Hey. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I'm in the Lord's army, yes sir. I may never march in the infantry,
Well, all right. That's it. I hope you guys had a great time. We'll see you all next week. Hey, hit the mute.